So this is both our main and secondary irrigation pumps. And they feed off to the valve system. Which controls distribution of water to any selection or a combination of micro sprinklers, drip irrigation, and the big overheads. Okay, this is the Pepper's row. Those are tomato peppers developing. They're a long time to harvest. I think they're 120 days. You can see they're doing pretty well though. Pretty happy. These next peppers up here are orange bells. They're still green, not ripening yet. These big long peppers are yellow super heavyweight hybrids. Those aren't ripening yet either, but when they do, they'll be about a half pound a piece. And they're supposed to be a delicious and beautiful pepper, so we're looking forward to those too. Those are more orange bells in here. There's some mini red bells. You can see one that's starting to ripen. A couple more nice green ones here. There's an orange bell that's ripening. See a green one just above it. And lots more over here. And more hidden amongst the foliage, of course. And up here, of course, there's jalapenos. You can see there's lots and lots of those. These are spicy too. Every once in a while I get brave and I bite into one. And then I'm wishing I had a glass of water handy and some bread. But they are delicious. They make excellent salsas and stuff. All kinds of other tasty dishes. Here are the emerald giant peppers. These are developing new ones since my last harvest. They're starting to size up decent. They're beautiful peppers. I'm definitely going to grow more of these Emerald Giants. These are an incredible strain. Beautiful. Big tall plants. Tremendous peppers. You can see some of these plants have gotten so big I had to stake them up. And of course there's the chocolate habaneros. These are another long-term harvest pepper. These are supposed to turn like a chocolatey purple color when they're ripe. As of yet, they're still red, and they're not hot at all. They're not spicy at all. But ultimately, they'll become extremely spicy, supposedly more than jalapenos. And these are purple pepper. These are called tequila sunrise. These are a beautiful pepper also. In the background, you can see the tomatoes that are surviving, barely. The blight's done quite a bit of damage this year, but we did manage to combat it enough to get a successful harvest. Our yields are probably about 10% of normal this year. These here are cayenne peppers. These are still in their development stages. And these are going to have to go under some protection in order to finish out their harvest. But you can see some small cayenne peppers coming on there. Over here is some parsley. It needs a little weed tending. But you can see there's some beautiful parsley in here. Can't wait to make some nice chicken noodle soup with that and some fresh carrots. And onions and all kinds of other tasty little treats, of course. Down here is another stage of Emerald Giants. We're going to try and run some frost protection on these and see if we can't bring them out to harvest. Hoping for a late fall this year. And over here we got some dill. Oh, there's some weeds growing in there too. But that's alright. It's an old bed. Right here we got some cilantro that's freshly seeded, fresh tilled seeded soil. We hear a tractor in the background. That's Joey Lydon harvesting. Over by the corn you can see the nasturtiums. Beautiful different color flowers. Nasturtiums are edible. They have kind of a crunchy, sweet flavor, kind of like a lettuce almost at first, and with a peppery, very peppery aftertaste. Both the leaves and flowers are edible, and they're quite a delicious treat to add into a salad. Sorry about the bounce there. flower and the leaf. Of course, there's weeds growing up through here too, but next year things will be planned a little differently, a little more efficiently. Freshly tilled soil, ready for planting. Our white currant cherry tomatoes. These have survived the blight in profound ways. they're doing incredibly well, actually. And these are a delicious, delicious cherry tomato. Can never walk by these plants without tasting one of these. Look at that beautiful dark green foliage coming out there too. These are doing really well. And on the other side we have some big rainbows. These are a delicious tomato. They're hanging in there. Spent a lot of time spraying copper sulfate this year. You can see new fruits developing, new flowers coming on. These plants are still growing. If we can protect them from frost, we might be able to push our harvest time out just a bit. Anyway, some of these now, let's see, where were we before the battery ran out? Showed you the white currants, showed you the big rainbows, showed you the strain that died out very quickly. I don't remember what strain that was. I'll have to look that up on the back. So let's tomatoes are hanging in there. They're like a table slicer kind of thing, but you can see that the blight is putting a hurt on them too. Carrots are doing well down there. Those are happy. Melons are, most of them are still doing pretty good. Some of them are dying off to the blight, but you can see them hiding in amongst the weeds. Hard to control the weeds around the melons. They're just such a sprawling plant. You can't mow. You mow back the vine you're trying to produce. And hand weeding. 200 feet long by 20 feet wide. Quite a chore. So melons we just let grow. We do a couple of mow backs on the edge in the beginning of the season to control weeds and let the melons be established. And that's pretty much it. And they grow through the weeds and they don't mind and we don't mind. These are a plum tomato here. These are a San Marzano. These are originally from Italy. They're quite a delicious plum tomato. You can see they're struggling to hang on. There's new growth coming on, but you can see where the blight has done its damage. Let's see what else we got up in these beds here. We got nasturtiums, another round of those coming on. Those are doing well since I went back and weeded around them again. Perking back up, beautiful colors coming in. They really look spectacular next to the habanero peppers with all their reds and oranges. And let's see, down here we've got two rows of leeks, Tandora and Pandora from Johnny Selected Seeds. They're looking nice, all weeded out and strawed up. They're developing quite well. Got some green Selects staple slicers on there growing. Got some new flowers and new growth coming on. These plants haven't given up, so I won't give up on them either. I'll keep spraying with copper sulfate. These are Amish paste tomatoes. These are a wonderful sauce and canning tomato. They lack a little bit of flavor as just like an eating tomato, but once you can them and cook them off, oh man, they're delicious. Look at this, we got new ones coming on and new flowers coming on in front of that. They've been really, really resistant to the blight. These plants have been incredibly resistant to the blight. You can see clusters of nice tomatoes. And then, of course, you can see a little bit of rot in there, too, from the rain shot we got the other day. But that's okay. We'll just cut that out and make sauce. These are white Tomasol tomatoes. These have been splitting a lot because of the uneven rain that we've had this year, uneven watering. And so they're really good when they don't split, but a lot of them have been hurt by the blight and split, and they get messed up. But you can see a ton of new green ones coming on. And the plants are actually pretty healthy, given the weather and climate we've had. You can see all kinds of new growth coming on those guys back there, too. You can see where some of the tomatoes died. I went back and planted cucumbers in their place. You can see some cucumbers coming on right there, growing. Those are Boston pickling. And over here we've got some Marketmore 76 growing. And you can see all the flowers that are coming on and new cucumbers that are coming on. They're doing pretty well. They're pretty happy. Over here we have a hybrid grape tomatoes. These are just incredibly sweet and delicious. These tomatoes are just... man, they're good. Taste Buds has been buying a lot of these for their salads and stuff. And they're just incredibly delicious. Can't get enough of those either. There's actually a couple different varieties here. There's some bigger ones that are more of a plum shape. And some more rounder ones. Smaller ones and bigger ones. Of course, you can see the other side of the peppers in the background there. And let's see, here's a Milky Way Moon and Stars melon. That's a beautiful melon. Not quite ripe yet. What else we got in here? I'm sure there's a bunch of ripe melons I gotta come through and harvest in here. Oops. Verde Grimpante, green climbing melon. These are pretty delicious when they ripen. We've had a hard time with ripening on those this year. Everything's had a hard time this year, I guess I should say. Here you go. The other moon and stars was a long Milky Way moon and stars. And this is a regular moon and stars. Moon and stars, of course, because of the little moon and star spots that they have. Some of these actually get a big, beautiful, like, moon or half crescent moon design on them in the yellow. They're quite an incredible looking melon. That one's approaching ripe. They're a long time to harvest. They're 90 days. You can see where the blight's been getting into all the melon vines. Oh, there's a Charleston gray that went bad. Aha! Charente. These are a cantaloupe-type melon. Not quite ripe yet either. And these haven't had the flavor this year from lack of sunlight. There's a couple more. There's a couple more. Here's a yellow canary that's trying to ripen up, but of course the blight has come in and wiped them out. Just like everything else. Jeez. Well, it doesn't make it easy to get to everything. That one's getting there. That one's almost there. Nope. Okay, that's enough melons. That's cilantro going to seed in that row there, by the way. We'll capture that seed for next year. Oh, what do we got in here? Freshly planted cabbage, broccoli, cauliflower, and then we go up here. We got our big kale plant and some mini heads of red cabbage. And then we got in these two closer beds to us, up to that first grass strip right there, is Denver half-long carrots and atomic red carrots. This would ordinarily, by the way, be extremely dry, but because it just irrigated last night, you can see that the soil's very damp. And of course, there's scallions here. Those are working toward finished for the fall. And then Oriole orange switch chard, which we recently mowed back so that it could come back for a fall harvest. Some of it's come back, some of it hasn't. And then we've got a couple of rows of a couple different kinds of spinach. We got a Bloomsdale long standing and a Savoy leaf spinach. 48 and 40 days to harvest, respectively. This is a bed of scallions also. Unfortunately, wasn't able to get out here and get the weeding done that I need to get done this year. So next year things will be mulched a little better. These are a red scallion. These are a, well, actually not a red, they're a purple. These are a deep purple F1 scallion. These are just, was kind of a test year for these, just to see what they come out like, if people like them, that kind of thing. And over here we got the makeshift greenhouse structure made out of 6-inch remesh and 4 mil plastic. And underneath the makeshift greenhouse, which is not complete yet, by the way, so don't be alarmed, is oregano. This is a Italian oregano. And it's delicious. I've been trying it and using it in sauces and salsa and all of our homemade organic products. And over here is bush basil. This is a spicy bush basil, or verde basil. It's also very, very pungent, very spicy, delicious. It adds a really wonderful flavor to salsas and sauces and pestos and all kinds of wonderful things. We'll be growing a whole lot more of this next year, for sure. Over here we got some broccoli that we're letting go to seed for next year's seed lot. These are an experimental plant that we decided to try this year. These are called naranjilla. And they are actually a South American orange, effectively. They're basically a little bigger than a grape, and they taste just like an orange. They're 180 days to harvest. They were started March 22nd and is now September 17th, I believe. And they are still still growing. But you can see that they're starting to develop flowers and they're getting ready to set fruit. Hopefully we can protect them long enough to... actually, that's the first flower on this plant. Look at that. You guys got to be here for it. There you go. So we're going to have naranjilla pretty soon. And those are going to be interesting to try. And maybe next year we'll grow a bunch of those. Those might be an interesting addition to our market. You can see old rows of corn that were harvested from earlier this summer. Those are now in the drying stage, and we'll be selling those for decorative purposes for Halloween. And there's also another fresh stage of bodacious corn in here. Which may or may not make it before frost, but it never hurts to try. I guess that concludes the tour of the garden, with the exception of our wild thistle flower, which we let grow just because they're so beautiful when they flower. Look at the purple on these things. Check that out. Camera can't even do it justice, I don't think. But anyway, that's why we let them grow. So, hopefully you'll tune in next time for another tour. Thanks for watching. Come back to more organics as soon as you can. Bye. One other thing. Here we are back at the upper north corner of the garden again. Just added 38 raspberry plants for next year. New row. So by next fall, we should have Nova raspberries also, and those are delicious too. Thanks again for listening. Take care.